Welcome back. My name is Joe. You've once again settled in at the Joe is Hungry channel, wrapped in pita bread, flash cooked, melted, literally right here within the city limits of Fairmount, Georgia. Before we get started, I would like to extend a special shout out to Moochie in my Discord for helping me with research on today's video. Also, I would like to give a special shout out to particularly Pirate in my Discord for maintaining the Joe is Hungry score spreadsheet. I have links in the description below. Kyle and Grace, Cody and Ryan, Corey and Steph, congratulations for tying the knot. Max, Taylor, Spencer and Blake, Roberto, Azalea, Drew and Kevin, Manny, Matt, Miranda and Nick, Keith and Andrew. I want to wish a very special Joe is Hungry birthday shout out to each and every one of you. With that out of the way, let's move on with this video because it's time to head back to Subway and check out a new menu item. This is actually an addition to an existing menu lineup called the Subway Sidekicks. They've been around for quite a while now and consist of a footlong cookie, a Cinnabon footlong churro, and the Auntie Annie's footlong pretzel. I actually tried all these in a live stream a few months ago, and truthfully, I was not impressed. But hopefully Subway's gonna do a little bit better this time. The footlong sidekick dippers come in three versions and are made with soft and warm flatbread, filled and rolled with meat, and or melted cheese with one side of 10 dipping sauces. I have those on the screen and in the description below. The first one is a chicken cheese sidekick dipper, and it is made with tender chicken strips rolled into 2 6-inch wraps, making 12 inches. The default and recommended dipping sauce is honey mustard, but you can change that. The second choice is a double cheese sidekick dipper, and it is made with melted shredded Monterey cheddar and American cheese rolled into 2 6-inch toasted wraps, and is automatically paired with peppercorn ranch. And lastly is a pepperoni cheese sidekick dipper, which is what we're doing today, thanks to good people that helped me choose by participating in this week's food poll. This sidekick dipper is made with spicy pepperoni and melted American cheese, again rolled into 2 6-inch toasted wraps, paired with Baja Chipotle dipping sauce. According to Subway, each one of these are supposed to weigh in at 136 grams or 4.80 ounces. If you break out the calculator, do a little bit of fuzzy cat math, you come up with a preliminary, and I do stress preliminary, middle of the road, 63 cents an ounce. But here at the Joe is Hungry channel, we embrace the trust but verify business model, because we will find out for sure later in the video when we do the Joe is Hungry weight test and calculate the actual real out the door fast food price per ounce. So let's see if Subway can clear this hurdle, serve these things piping hot, and roll on over to Subway in Fairmount, Georgia. Actually, we're not quite there yet. I'm still in my parking lot. So let's go ahead and pick up our sidekicks. I've got my dippers. Let's do the Joe is Hungry temperature test. Dipper number one is 195.4 degrees Fahrenheit. Dipper number two is 165.7 degrees Fahrenheit. Dipper number three is 162.7 degrees Fahrenheit. If you've been watching my channel any length of time, you know I like my temperatures at 140 degrees or above. Hotter is always better. Actually, I am quite surprised. I've never really got anything this hot from Subway. So today, Subway, apparently you get it because you passed the Joe is Hungry temperature test. Now it's time to get my surgical suite open, get ready for business, cut this thing open, see what's inside, head back to the studios and
do the Joe is Hungry weight test. And as usual, in every video, we always take off for the packaging. In other words, we set the tear on the scales.
Dipper number one weighs in at 4.50 ounces or 128 grams. Dipper number two weighs in at 4.65 ounces or 132 grams. Dipper number three is 4.60 ounces or 129 grams. Well, the weights are all fairly consistent with those numbers. Subway, Fairmount, you pass. The Joe is Hungry consistency weight test. However, they are consistent at one thing. They are below their own serving weights. And before anybody asks, I did not include the dipping sauce in the weights, as in the nutritional information, they were not included. However, they're down just a little bit, not quite 10%. You really can't blame the people working there. They assemble these things exactly the way instructed. But today, I still can't give them a pass on the Joe is Hungry weight test. Now, if you add them all up, average them out, do the math, it runs the price up a little bit more to 65 cents an ounce. So now it's time to do the next phase, the one and only, the Joe is Hungry big reveal. This is what they look like, and this is what they're supposed to look like. This is what they look like, and this is what they're supposed to look like. Well, we've seen what they look like, and they kind of resemble their ad photos. Seems like I'm seeing a little bit more pepperoni hanging out, maybe a little bit more cheese. Kind of hard to say. Anyway, we've seen how much they were. Not the greatest price, not the worst. But that only leaves one more test to do, and I think everybody knows what it is. It's time for the Joe is Hungry bite test. So it is, bite test, engage. I'm not really a big fan of the dipping sauce. However, it is a necessity because this is sort of dry and bready, but at least they do give you a choice of dipping sauce. I can taste the sandwich pepperoni, although I don't think they could have sliced it any thinner and still held together. I can even taste the cheese. It kind of gives it a better texture, but it sort of leaves me wanting for more. I do like the chewiness of the pita bread, but I really don't have anything else to say because really there's not a whole lot there to talk about unless my shadowy counterpart has something to add when we look back into the historical records and do the Joe is Hungry sneak-a-doodle bite. Sneak-a-doodle bite number one. Sneak-a-doodle bite number two. Sneak-a-doodle bite number three. You know, I think what you said in the last video was wrong.
Wrong about what?
I'm the one that she likes. You're the ghost, and don't forget it.
Whatever, dude. Keep dreaming. Anyway, let's move on with this video. I can taste the pepperoni. It actually has a little bit of heat, about a 4 on the 1 to 10 Joe Heatometer. I can taste the cheese. Maybe could have used a little bit more than that. This is kind of a bready thing. So, now it's time to give this thing a score. If you don't know my scale is 1 to 10, 9 being the best. Anything above 9 is a once in a lifetime experience and almost never achieved. 5 and down is that slippery slope to the pits and depths of fast food hell. So let's go ahead and give this the score that it truly deserves.
Subway. The staff, Fairmount, definitely on point. The temperature test, they definitely knocked it out of the park. No question. The weight test,
not so much. You were within 10% of your posted serving weight, so today I'm not going to bust your chops, at least not now. The price sort of has that giving us less for more vibe. Boost the old profit margins, right? But Subway, in spite of the meager ingredients, this thing actually does have flavor. And you do provide dipping sauce. It does help. And the price is not terrible. So today, Subway, I'm gonna have to go 5.5. That is my number. This is my review, and hopefully I will see you in the next video.